How's it, guys? Thank you so much for watching the webinar yesterday. To all the guys that were part of it, you guys are champions. We had a discussion about quality assurance and quality control, and really just dashing out where we are as an industry in terms of inspection and the training that's attached to it. We got a good response yesterday from everybody who We got a really good response yesterday from everybody who was in the show. And a lot of guys had missed the show because we streamed live on Zoom. So I saw it fitting for us to make the webinar available for you so you can be a part of the discussion. I hope that you enjoy it. Thank you so much. Please feel free to like this video and share it with your network. Enjoy. Yeah. Saying that as a welding and fabrication inspector, the sort of training you get is suitable for inspection. And the first thing we've got to understand is inspection is only a function of quality control, right? Inspection is one of the functions. Testing is another. Reviews is another function of quality control. So the training we get doesn't cover the scope of work that we're responsible for, especially on a construction project. Never mind a shutdown. If you're working on a project, some of your responsibilities are great. Like, for example, most of the time, setting up the quality management system from the ground. So putting the quality management system in place, putting all the processes in place for you to take the project from wherever it is, right? Whatever phase it is in the project, right up until handover. That's your responsibility, right? You're not just responsible for going to look at welds and sites. And that's fine, right? You can go to the site, you can check if there's a dog leg on a pipe, you can identify porosity, misalignment, you know the different grain types of the materials, you know how the different materials behave. That's great, but can you hand over the project? And that's our responsibility, gentlemen. And the answer is, the sort of training that's required for somebody to do that, it just wasn't available at the time when we were training. It wasn't available. So you qualify like myself as an inspector. And I've worked in the industry before I did my level one, I worked as a supervisor for 6 years, and I was a young man at the time, but proper hands-on experience in construction. And I was under the assumption that, hey, because I've got so much experience in construction and engineering, I'll be suitable for inspection. And you do the inspection course, and you think, you know, this is all you need to put you, give you the benefits or the benefit for employment. And when you get there, you don't meet the requirements, right? One, because what the employer wants is not what you've been trained to understand, not what you've been trained to facilitate. Please leave a comment if there's anything that you would like to share or anything that you find to be relevant or irrelevant in our conversation, and put in your comments below. We'd love to hear it, no matter what platform it's on, if it's on LinkedIn, YouTube, or Facebook. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed the webinar, and I hope that there was some information provided that was insightful, that at least got you thinking, curious, or interested. Please be sure to like this video and be kind enough to share with your network. Thank you, and see you next time.